Hi, hello. This is we will be learning about how to create a GL account in SAP FICO. So in the last class, we were learning about how to complete. We have done with the configuration of general ledger accounts, right? Now let's see how to create a particular ledger account in SAP. So there are three types of methods which can be used to create a particular ledger account in SAP. Like you can say, centrally we can create chart of accounts level, company code level, etc. So basically we will be creating a general ledger account at company code level. Okay, so let us see. So these are the things which we have done in the last session. Now let us see how to create a general ledger account. So here we are. So we can create it both at chart of accounts level, company code level, and central level. Usually we create it at central level. Why? Because this central level data consists of both chart of accounts data and company codes data. That is why it is always advisable to create a particular ledger at central level. So the transaction code to create a particular ledger is FS00, and menu path for the same is SAP Easy Access, Accounting, Financial Accounting, General Ledger, Master Records, GL Accounts, Individual Processing, FS00 Central. Here we can see we are now into SAP Easy Access screen. That means you are now into front end screen. All the configurations which we were doing, we have done everything in the back end screen. Now we are doing it in the front end screen. Okay. Now, so this is a T code for central creation, like FS00, and chart of accounts is FSP0, and company code level it is FSS0. So as I said, we usually go with FS00. So here we can see. So let us create the same thing in SAP also. So here I have given a chart. Like four accounts we can create it, eight accounts, four groups, eight accounts. So from each group we are going to create two accounts. Okay, so first we will create ledgers, then we will be posting the ledger. So first we create it at center level. So as I said, we can directly enter T code here and get into the screen, the SAP Easy Access screen, or we have another way, like we will get into the menu part. So SAP Easy Access, Accounting, Financial Accounting, General Ledger, Master Records, GL Accounts, Individual Processing. Then we have FS00 central. Okay, so here we will create. So as I said, I have given a group of accounts. Now let's see one by one. The first is liability. So let us create a liability that is nothing but a retained earnings account. And so here I have given the you know, a brief structure of how to create it. So let's see. So first we have to update our company code. So our company code was DEL5, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, it was DEL8. Okay, enter. Then here we're going to give our account number. So we said that 4 should be our length of GL account number, right? This is display, this is edit, and this is create. So here we are going to go and click on create. Now, for a GL account, we have 5 segments. Like one is type description, here we can see. Type description, control data, create bank interest, keywords, translation, information. So these are the 5 segments of a particular ledger account. So first we will be putting here, we will be going with first segment called create type description tab. Then account group, what is account group for this? It's a liabilities, right? Okay. So we said in the back end that our account group would be 1999, right? 6 digits we gave in the chart of accounts. That is why it is not picking up now. Okay, so first account group. So we have done this creations. Now let's enter into postings. Let us see how we can post a particular ledger in SAP. So basically, posting of a GL invoice. So here is an example I've given, and the T code is F-02, and the menu path for the same is SAP Easy Access, Accounting, Financial Accounting, General Ledger, Posting, General Ledger, Posting F-02. Let's go with an example. For example, if we say rent paid account data to bank account, okay, ours is rent paid account data to bank account. So the amount would be somewhere around, let's say, 50,000. Okay, and the text is being rent paid. So as we were discussing earlier, as we have discussed earlier also, that in SAP, it is not compatible with numbers. So it is mostly with numbers. So we have to be very careful when we are doing this. So what is the rent paid account data to bank? So here it will not understand DR or TO2. Instead of that, we are supposed to give a posting key called 40 and 50. And these are the standard posting keys in SAP, 40 and 50. So let's see how to post it. Here also we have it. So here we see, okay. So rent paid through check, for example, 5,000. Let's say on today's date. Okay. So here I'm going to give the date. Now, so instead of TO2, DR, we are giving posting key 40, rent paid account you are debiting, amount is 5,000, and we are crediting it to 50, posting key 50, bank account, and amount is 5,000, and the text is being rent paid. So hold this process, let us do it in application. So here, let us go with the menu bar. So SAP Easy Access, accounting. financial accounting, general ledger, document entry. Here we have F-02. Okay. F-02. Now what we are supposed to do is date. Here in SAP, instead of we giving manual entries or manual date, filling up manually, we have got a shortcut in SAP. We have got a calendar also. If you hit F4 over here, you will get a calendar. From this calendar, if you hit F2, automatically today's date will be displayed. So here is the date. So I just hit the F4 and F2 for the date. And by default, the document type for the general ledgers is SA. That we know it. So by default, the document type here is SA. And company code. So whatever company code you are working with, that company code. Then period, currency. Posting key, 40. Because we are debiting. Which account are we debiting? We are debiting account called rent pay in our example. Let's see. In our example, we said the account should be rent paid. Right. So if we simply write rent paid over here, rent paid account, it will give an error because, as I said, SAP is not compatible with characters. That is what we have assigned some numbers to this particular accounts. So hit F4. So filter it with your company code, enter. Rent paid. Enter. Okay. Amount. Let's say amount 5,000 or 50,000. So 5,000, let's say. Then text. If you see here, narration. And it is showing a mandatory entry. What we have done? We have made this as a mandatory. So being rent paid. So till here, debit items we have completed successfully. We have given a debit date, we have given debit account, we have given debit posting key, we have given debit amount and debit text. So all the mandatory entries for a particular ledger to be completed debit wise we have done. Now next line item is nothing but credit item. So next line item, credit posting key 50. Which account are we crediting? So hit F4 and select the account. We're going for bank, so we are crediting it to bank. So select bank, enter. Okay, now amount star. So for which business area are you paying this rent? So if you remember, we have created business areas, right, with four characters. So let us see where are we, what are our business areas. Yeah, Dell in India and Dell in UK. So let's go for DEL1 star. Why are we giving plus and star? To copy debit text, debit amount. So these are the shortcut keys to enter over here. Enter. So we have successfully given the debit posting and credit posting. As soon as we do debit and credit, it is advised to save the data. Because you are observing their next line item. So we can see this next line item for 999 times. So we should be very cautious. Once we debit and credit, we have to save it. So same thing, let us see over here. So rent paid to account. So you can see document date, type, company code, period, currency, posting key 40, and account was share capital here, for example. Okay, amount stars plus save. Same thing if you are talking over here, it is done. Okay. Now let's do another entry, bank account data to sales account. So same thing, same T code F-02 to get the particular date, that is today's date, hit F4, then F2, type SA, company code, period, currency, then the present posting key for debit is 40. So hit F4 to select the account you want to debit it. our entry was bank account data to sales account 1 lakh. So we have to debit now bank account. Enter. So bank is ABC Bank. Enter. Let's say 1 lakh. Okay. So business area DEL1. Text being sales made, or you can try being sales done. Okay, so debit things are successfully done. Now next line item is nothing but credit item. So posting key 50, account. Which account you are crediting? Hit F4. So we are crediting sales account. So hit F4 and select the sales account. Enter. Enter. Okay. Enter once again. Okay. DELI. So instead of typing amount and text again, let us give amount debit amount star and text as plus. Enter, save. So successfully we have done with two documents. Now let us view these documents, because we are posting documents, but we have to have a display of that documents posted also, right? So let us post the documents. So where can we post it? Where can we view it? So here we can see, to display the DL documents, the transaction code is FB03. So here we can view the documents. So menu path for the same is SPRO, SAP Reference ING, Accounting, Financial Accounting, General Ledger, Document. Then we have FB03 display. So let me make it here also. So menu path for the same is SAP Easy Access, Accounting, Financial Accounting, General Ledger. So I am giving in a shortcut, that is General Ledger GL, Document. Then we have Display, FB03. Okay, and this is the direct equal. So FB03, here we are. So whichever document number you want to display, we can. So go here. One I want to display. First document. Document number. Company code fiscal year. Enter. So as we enter, it will show you. So the data where we can see the total data in preview tab, particular box. That in SAP terminology, it is called transaction data. So for one document, we have two types of view or two types of data. One is transaction data, another one is line item data. So the data where you can see a box called data entry view, this is called transaction data. And the where you can see company code, posting key, GL account number, description, amount, currency and all, this is called line item data. So we can see both the things over there. One is transaction data and other one is company code data. Okay. Now I want to view the second document. Let's see that.
So go back. Document number 2. Company code, fiscal year, enter. Okay. So this is what we have done. Bank account data to sales account. So it is showing. If you want to check it up, the debit data also, posting key debit data. If you double click on that line item, in SAP terminology, we call line item for a particular GL account. So we don't call it as general ledger account or ledger account or account every time. We use a term called here line item. Here the line item means the GL account. Okay. So in this way, we are going to post the accounts and view the accounts. So the next topic here goes as now. So this is all about the basic part of the enterprise structure, financial accounting settings and general ledger accounting settings. Now we will be entering something depth of that, that is accounting documents. So what exactly you mean by accounting documents in SAP? In SAP there are two types of accounting documents. One is original documents. What is original documents? And the other one is processing documents. Okay, so what are these original documents? So original documents is nothing but example. Invoices, bills, bills of exchange, vouchers. These are all our original documents. These are called original data. Talking about processing documents. So what are the processing documents in SAP? These are called processing documents. Basically, there are four types of processing documents. One is hold documents, park documents, fast data entry, and you have recurring entries, right? So let us see one by one. First, we will be talking about hold documents. What exactly are these hold documents? In SAP, hold documents, these are for temporary entry purpose. So these when we use these documents is for the temporary entry purpose. Why temporary purpose? For example, if you don't have a complete information to post a document, okay? So, for example, if we have incomplete information into company code. If you don't have a complete information to post that particular data into company code, so what we can do in SAP is we can hold it. We can hold it. Then, another disadvantage of this is we can hold maximum for 2 days only, not more than 2 days. So usually it takes only 2 days. After 2 days, you have to gather the information and post it into the company code. Otherwise, automatically it disappears or destroys. And here in hold documents, to complete these hold documents, we require a temporary account number or temporary document number, which we have to give separately. And it is a technical part that the program name to convert hold documents is RFTPM PBLU. This is basically done in transaction code called SE38 by the evaluators. We need not do this, but just for the information I have given the hold document name over here. So what we'll do is, let's do the configuration steps for hold documents. Let us create one hold document. So same thing where we have posted there itself, SAP Easy Access, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, document entry, then we have F-02. So here we are going to fold it, the particular document. So document name, F4, F2. Type, essay. Okay. Company code, period, currency. Okay. Posting key, 40. Account. So let's say same rent paid. Enter. Let's say some amount 50,000. Document held. For incomplete information. Okay. Then posting key 50. Which account? So let's say bank account. Enter amount star. Update the business area. Text. Enter. Now go to document on menu bar and see held or hold. So once we hold that particular, trying holding that particular document, it would ask you or it would pop up for the temporary document number. So this temporary document number will be given to you in the BBP. But then here we don't have any live BBP with us. BBP, I think it is business blueprint. So let's give our own customized number. So let me go with a number called 500, for example. Enter. So when I give a temporary document number, it would say this particular document will be saved in that particular temporary document number assigned. Okay. Now let's, after posting, let us see how to, after creating, after getting the full information, let us assume 2 days has been elapsed and we got the complete information to post that particular document into the company code. So when we got that information, we have to post it to the company code. So posting also the same T code actually. So same F-02. We post it here only. Document date, F4, F2, type SA, company code, period, currency. Now, here, go to document on menu bar and say get held documents. So what are the held documents available in this particular client? So it will show you all the particular documents. Either you go there and hit select the get held documents, or directly hit F5, it will show you. Then here it would ask you that temporary document number which you have given to update it to the database, right? So I have given 500. So let us see, and it would ask for the username also, and it would be by default. Enter. So when you enter it, it will retrieve that particular document and show you the status, whether this is the document you wanted to save it. You save. No, you want this document to be deleted. Yes, you can do that also. For example, I want to save this particular document, nothing but posting. Then I can say post by getting to document on menu bar and say stimulate or post, one and the same. And if you want to delete it, yes, go to document, edit on menu bar and select delete item. Okay. So now I'm going to document and saying stimulate. Stimulate is nothing but posting. So it has stimulated. Now let's go and say stimulate general ledger.
Okay, so it has tabulated and it is showing you what is the amount, what is the posting date, what's the fiscal year and which account it has been posted, so on. Then now go back once. Now go to document. See post. Now this particular document is posted. So you can see the end message as document is posted into the company code. So this particular document have been posted into the company code now. Okay. Now, so whatever documents we have posted, we have to display of the documents, right? We should have a display of those documents. So document FB03 display. So give the document number, company code, fiscal year, enter. So we can see here. So that document was automatically, that temporary document number have been erased or elapsed, then new, the original document number it has picked up. So that is why we got the document number as 3 and it is saved. So this is all about your parked document, held documents. So next very important documents is parked documents. So this is what usually, you know, junior associates or junior SAP consultants will do it in SAP project. So usually, mostly we work with parked documents there. So what are these parked documents? Actually, same, these parked documents are also for temporary entry purpose, like your whole documents, but there are some slight differences. So these are also for temporary entry purpose used if there is no complete information to post the document into company code. Okay, so if you don't have a complete information to post it, then we go with the parked documents. Now, but here the difference is we can park it for 1 month. So there it was for, so there it was for 2 days only, right? And here the advantage is we can park it for 1 month. And it does not require any temporary document number. Like your whole documents, here it will not ask you any type of temporary document number. That means the document will be saved automatically or will be parked automatically in the regular or original number range itself. And usually these documents, these parked documents can be parked with higher amounts. So usually these are parked with higher amounts and requires higher authorities approval to post it. Yes, you create it and once you're posting it into the database, it requires higher authorities approval to post it. So it is mandatory that once you want, as a consultant or as a junior consultant, wanted to post it into the database, so have to get approval from the higher authorities to post it into the database. Okay, now let's do the same thing, the posting things. So first we will be talking about the configuration steps for parked documents. Let's see what are the configuration steps for parked documents. So first we create a parked document. So basically we create a parked document in FDAS65. Later on, like for example, if you want to make any changes in that, after creation you want to make any changes, yes, we can make it, and we can make it in FBV2. Then the change document have to be displayed. So basically it is displayed in FBV3. Then once you get the complete information to post it to the database, so we are going to post it to the FBV0. Display changes is FBV5. So we'll do better in the application. So for example, let's say we park this document and the entry would be, let's say, bank account data to sales account. So SAP Easy Access, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, then document entry, then we have FD65, general document parking. Okay, document date. Document date is nothing but F4, F2. So we are going to give F4, F2. So the type is SA, company code, period, currency, then posting key 40, account. Hit F4 and select the account. So let's say bank account. Enter amount. Let's say 3 lakh. Okay. Then text being sales done. Okay. Being sales done and document parked for incomplete information. So it is not taking the letters. So we have it document, sorry, characters. It takes only 40 characters for text. Oh. Information. Okay. Then posting key 50, account. So we have to credit the sales account. Sales account. Enter. Amount star. Text plus enter. Save. So if you see now here, it is not asking you any temporary document number. It automatically got posted or got parked in the original document number itself. So our original sequence number was 4, right? Now the same number it is showing over here, 4. So it has got parked in that particular document. Now after parking a document, let's say after a few days, because we have a time for 1 month, okay? And we got to know that the sales income was not 1 lakh and it was there was an increase of 10% in that and we didn't record it. So 1 lakh 10% is 10,000. That means that the total sales invoice should be updated for 1 lakh 10,000. So changes have to be made. Yes, where we can make the changes is SAP Easy Access, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, document, park documents, and here we have FBB2. So here, give company code, document number you want to make changes. Company code, fiscal year, enter. Okay, now. So it was updated, sorry, 3 lakh 10%, that is 30%, 30,000. So double click on the first line item and update the amount as 3 lakh 30,000. So let's say document posted. Or document edited. Okay, so we are going to change it for next line item also. So hit on next line item, shift control F7, 3 lakh 30,000, enter, save. So here we can see the changes have been made and the document got edited and changed, edited and saved. Now whatever documents we have edited it, so we should have a display of that particular screen also. So FBB3, here we can have a display of that posted document. So it is FBB3. So give company code, document number, fiscal year, enter. So we can see the amount has been changed and even there is a change of the text also. So in this way, we can confirm that the changes have been done successfully, then yes, now the time has come. So here we can see the display changes, where we can see what all the changes have been done to a particular document, right from creation till posting. So whatever changes have been done with user details, it will be given to us, right? So let's see. Okay, now display changes. So here we are going to check the details of this. So give the company code, document number which you are giving. Fiscal year, enter. Click on all changes. So whatever changes we have done, it will show. So what was the old entry, what is a new entry, which field we have changed, on which date we have changed, everything in and out details will be given over here. Now the time has come. So first, let's say it's been 28 days we have done with the entering the data into the PARC documents. Now we have got time that we need to post it into the company code. So when we want to post it to the company code, so first what we have to do is we have to sort out that all the documents. So we have got that information. Then we are going to raise a request or raise a mail to your manager or your authority, higher authority, whoever it is, to receive an approval from them. Because unless and until you receive an approval from your manager, you are not going to save the data you are not going to post that particular document into the company code. So let's say the team associates mails the manager regarding seeking the approval, or he can approve it or we can delete it also. Same thing we can do in the application also. We can approve the document, or else we can also delete that particular document. So how to approve it? So when he approves this, let us post that particular document into the database, that is company code. So here we can do it. So posting also and deleting also happens in the same T code, FBV0. Give company code, document number, fiscal year, enter. Okay, so yes, if we want to post this particular document into the database, yes, go to document and say post it. No, we want to delete it, we can even delete it. So I'm posting it. Okay, so successfully the document has been posted, and we have got the log messages document posted, and it is updated in green color. That means the document is posted. Now whatever document has been posted, we should have a display of it, right? So we can see it in FP03. So the next step where we can view the document is FP03. Give the document number, company code, fiscal year, enter. Okay, so here we can see 330,000, same. Right. So in this way, we work on with PARC documents in real time. So we create it, we change, we display, post or delete, and display changes. So mostly we will be working with PARC documents in real time. So PARC documents are, I can say the important data which as a student have to work on it. Next type of document is fast data entry. Let us do fast data entry, then we will talk about recurring. Fast data entry. So this is like only for name purpose. Namely, it is called fast data entry, but actually it is not a fast data entry. So it is not used in a way. Here we can post. Here we can post componentries at once, like one debit, three debits to one credit. So usually we call it as a componentries. So those sort of things we can post it here. Only disadvantage over here is we have to update text for each and every entry. So for each and every entry we have to give the documents. Okay. We have to give, for each and every entry we have to give the narration. So that is why this is very disadvantageous. So usually people will not work with fast data entry in real time. Okay, so for our example, let us see one document, fast data entry, how to make it. So same thing, same here only we can go ahead. So let us do the configuration steps. Let us see the configuration steps. So first let us create a fast data entry. So same thing we can do it in F-02. Okay, so same thing. Document entry F-02. Okay. Document date F4, F2, type SA, company code, period, currency. Then hit directly here on fast data entry. Fast data entry. Now here, posting key 40. Directly you can give posting key 40. Okay. Account. Hit F4 and select the account. So whichever account you want to do it, you can go for. But I told you, no, three debits, one credit. So we have to go for three debits, one credit. So let's go for rent paid first. Then let's say amount 50,000. Okay, let us go for 50,000. Then for which business area you are doing this rent? For which business area you are paying this rent? Okay, so let's say. Or else company code directly. Then another debit 40. 40. Then we check. What's happening? Which account you want a debit? So let's say now salary paid. All debits on the same date. Let us assume these all bills have to be paid on the same date. That is why we are going for this entry. Let's say same 5 lakh, for example. So towards same company code. And these two entries have to be credited to bank. So that is why posting key 50. Account. Bank. Okay. So bank, hit F4 and select the bank account. So bank. So both debit and credit should be equal, right? Now here we are giving debit entry as one entry for 50,000 and another entry for 5 lakh. So the total came is 5 lakh 50,000. So the credit should be
5,50,000. So every debit should have equal credit. That is why in debit we have given 50,000 and 5 lakh, right? So crediting we are giving only one account. So that credit should be total 5,50,000. 5,50,000. Enter. So business area DELI. Okay. Now, if we are hitting, if the document says fast data entry, if we are hitting enter and save, it should automatically save it, right? It should automatically save it, right? So, but here the disadvantage is it is popping up in blue color instead of giving you a green color message. That means it, whenever you see any line item in blue color while posting, it is assumed that it requires text. So if you are getting that blue color line item, you should understand that it is asking text. So you should give text for each and every line item. So here, if I assume this is a fast data entry, that is a time consuming process. I should give a text for each and every line item over here now. So double click on the first line item. Text being rent paid. Save. Okay. So you can see in the next line item also it will be there. So double click being salary paid. Save it. So till the last line item, it will keep on asking you the text. So it's mandatory that for each and every line item, we have to update text. Okay. So here, at the last item, it would also ask you the value date. So here the value date is nothing but the document date or posting date. And the text being rent and salary paid. Through bank, right? And now you will get a confirmation message that this particular document is posted into the company code. So now you can see posting document number, posting is only possible with 0. Okay, so the document is posted now. So now we got a successful message that the document has been posted. Now the same document you want to display. Yes, the same process. Where you haven't displayed the document, there itself it is. So FB03. Here we go. Give the document number, company code, fiscal year, enter. So obviously it has to show here. So but unfortunately it is not there. Let us see in the next document about this. Okay. For example, if we want to change this document, yes, here itself we can go and make the changes. Okay. Fine. Document. So, as we have completed the processing of this document, then you want to display it, it will not happen because batch input session will be completed. Once the batch input session is completed, viewing that particular document is impossible. Okay. Yeah. So not advisable about this. Okay. So this is all about your old documents. Okay. Park documents. And the next is fast data entry. So usually we mostly work with park documents and recurring documents in the real time. So basically it is advised more to practice on fast and recurring. So I'm sorry, park and recurring. Okay. So in our next session, we will be learning about the recurring documents. Okay. Thank you.